Hello students, welcome to the next session of STM32 in 4MCU series. In this session we will discuss about how to get started with STM32 Cube IDE. So once you download STM32 Cube IDE from st.com, so this will be the first page on which you can design your projects. So first we go to this file menu, then select new. In this portion you will see there are n number of options available. You can create C, C++ project, you can create STM32 project, or you can import your STM32 Cube MX project. So we are going to take here STM32 Cube. So let me select STM32 Cube project. So now you can see that your target selector is going to initialize. So this target selector is basically searching for the peripheral board. So here you can see you have two options, MCU or MPU selector. You can either select with the help of your MCU if you are aware about what kind of MCU is available to you. So you can select with this unit or you can select with the board. But the problem with this MCU and MPU selector is that you have to define each and every component separately. Means you have to define the core, you have to define the series, then line, package and other peripheral devices. So to the better purpose we select the board. So in this portion we have commercial part number. The commercial part number is Nucleo-L476. You can see here automatically it comes about nuclear L476RG, and in this right side you can see the same development board is available. So just click on this board and click on this bottom next option. So once you click on this, it will ask you to give name for your project. So let me give this name as LED_test. Okay, so just click on this finish so that it creates the project setup for you. Now it is asking to initialize all the peripherals in the default mode. As we have selected the board option, so it will initialize all the peripherals. So we need not to bother about that which peripheral I want to access or not. So we just click on this yes. So here you can see here it is initializing your device configuration tool. So remember one thing, your system should be connected to the Wi-Fi or to the some suitable internet, as whenever you are going to create a new project, you can see here some files are going to be downloaded. So these are the files which will be downloaded for the first time when you are going to create your test project. So we have to wait until this file is getting downloaded. So once we are done with this system configuration, you can see over here that on the left hand side under this you have different sections automatically created by this device drivers. So this one is an important part. Let me zoom this one. So this is your ARM Cortex M4 IC. So here it is written as STM32L476RG. It is based on ARM Cortex M4. So you can see these are the pins for this ARM Cortex. On the pins, every pin have its multiple functions. So once we select in the board mode, so some of the pins you are seeing in green color, they are automatically get initialized as per their functions. So let us read out. It's B1, that is here blue push button. So blue push button is attached at PC13. PC13 means port C, pin number 13. Similarly, you can see here you have PC0, PC1, PC2, PC3. So we can see other side there is a PC A, means port A, and here you can see it's port B. So the total, this core is divided into three port: port A, port B, port C. So the pin configuration you can see all over here. So you can read out the functions of each pin. So next we will be using PEFI. We can use any of the pin, but for this experiment we are going to use this pin PA5. You can see here USART, that is Universal Synchronous A Receiver Transmitter pair, this TX and RX that is attached at PA2 and PA3. Similarly, TMS is attached on PA13 that is used for GMS. So on clicking, just left click on this, you can see these all are the functions that has to be performed by this pin PA5. I want to use it as a GPIO, means I want to configure this pin as a general purpose input output. So this is the beauty of the software, that the same pin can perform the multiple operation. Means this pin can be used for ADC purpose, for serial peripheral interface, for generating timers, for generating interrupts. But I want to use this pin for GPIO mode. So I have to select a GPIO output. Why I am selecting this output? Because I want to blink an LED. So LED is an output device. So I have to select a particular pin which will be giving the output signal to the LED. Similarly, you can see by clicking on other pins, the same functions are available as per the pin diagram of this MCU. Okay, so this is, we can call it as a pin out view, where you can configure each and individual pins as per your requirement, as per your project capability. So next is this option. So after doing this, this IDE will give you automatic code generation. So by clicking on this option, you can create an automatic code. It will ask you, do you want to open the perspective window? Perspective window means where your code is written in C and C++ language. So we have to select it as yes. So again, it will be updating your hardware board because it is loading the code from there. So now it's already done, it's loaded. So you can see a complete C++ code is automatically generated by the software. You need not to worry about this complete, because you have initialized this board in a default mode. So some of the functions are already defined over here. So we have to search out for the portion where we have to write down the code. So here, you can find out here, it's written here as, because I want to access the GPIOs. So here it is written as user code begin and end. So this is the portion where we have to write down the code. So let me give an enter, make some space for this. So for writing this code, every instruction would be followed by, prefixed by HAL. HAL stands for Hardware Abstraction Language. Hardware Abstraction Layer or Language, it means you are coding the platform on the basis of the hardware. Means we are doing the coding part with respect to the hardware. In this case, our pin is now configured as the output pin, or is configured as the GPIO. So I want to use the functions of the GPIO. So how to use that? So first of all, press underscore and write it down GPIO. After writing GPIO, I am not sure ki what function I want to use. So press control and space. Here all are the functions related to GPIO you can see here. You can see with the help of a GPIO, you can generate external interrupt. You can initialize the interrupt, you can lock pin, you can read pin, means if you are attaching any of the sensors, so you have to read the data, you can toggle pin. So toggle means it will generate your high and low signal. So we have to blink the LED, so I have to select this function. So this one is your GPIO read and this one is your GPIO write. In this case, we are using the default function, that is a toggle pin. So in this case, you can see the parameters for this toggle pin function. It will be asked you GPIO type define and GPIO pin. So I have to just select this option, double click. So you can see, and automatically the function is written over there. Okay. So next here, you can see it's asking about GPIO X. X means which GPIO you are going to use, A, B, C. So I have selected as GPIO A. So I have to given here and capital GPIO A. Next, it is asking me which pen I have to use. Which pen I have to use? PA5, port A, pin number 5. So I will be declaring as underscore 5 and end this line with the colon. So if I remove the colon, you can see a question mark is there which says something is missing, and it is indicating you that your colon is missing. So you have to just press down the semicolon. In the next line, now I have to blink. It is a blink. So it will be running very fast because the crystal oscillator attached it has 80 megahertz. So the toggling frequency is very high. I have to insert the delay. So HAL underscore delay of 500 milliseconds. So this is delay we are going to use it. So after writing this delay, now we have to go to the next view, that is the debug view. So the complete this ID have three type of views: debug view, perspective view, and your pin configuration view. Okay, so here you can see now currently my perspective view is open. So I can see only two options, this MX and here it is a debug. So the two other. So we move to the third. First view we have already seen, that is a GPIO where we are doing the configuration part. Second is perspective view where we are writing the coding part. The third one is your debug view. Now let me click on this debug. So while debugging, it is building your project and just checking the, is there any mistake or is there any error in the project. So in the bottom you can see all your report. So just click on this OK. Yes, I want to select it for the main, select all, then OK. Proceed. OK. So here you can see there's some of the error has occurred. Some error has occurred. Now we have to clear. Now you can see I deliberately put up this error so that you can understand how to debug and identify what is the benefit of this debugger. You can see once I place my cursor over there, it says GPIO underscore pin underscore 5 is undeclared. It should be written as GPIO underscore PIN in caps lock. So I will change it with PIN and again I will run the debug mode. Again, select all and then click on OK. Now we will check, is there any other error? Okay, now this message will come then if you don't give any error. Just give him the allow access and go to the switch mode. So let me show how it runs. So here, now you can see once it goes into the debug mode, so the debug LED that is blinking here, this one is your debug LED, it is blinking in a multicolor fashion. Okay, so next we see how to run this code. So this one is the button to run this your main program. So once you are running your main program, your debug mode will be automatically switched off. So just click on this. And it's in the bottom you can find its debugger is verified, download verified successfully, means when you run this code, whatever it's doing, it is stop the debugger mode, check all this connection and the transfer this code into the MCU. Now we see what is happening inside this MCU. Here this one, this LED is your inbuilt LED which is blinking, this green LED you can see over there. So in this way you can see how your code is working. So this is the complete solution for your code. Thank you very much for this session. So in the next session, we will discuss about the timer configurations and the clock configurations. Thank you very much.